I am so happy right now. I'm happy that, we finally got Jacob back into the
I'm
fold.
back.
That's right.
For a while, I'm back.
Yeah,
Do I
he's
sound
back.
all muffly with this mask on?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I've also a bit of news. I went and had my antibodies and COVID antibodies test, and I have COVID antibodies, so I have a bit of a resistance to it. So that's good.
Which means basically all of us here have already had it.
Yeah, effectively. All of us who
So.
stayed here in the house have had it. And even Jake, you might have had it too, because where you were sick before this whole thing went down.
Yeah, I got sick in like December.
Yeah, so you may have had it beforehand.
Who knows?
Yeah.
I think people were actually joking about the possibility of it being over here before everybody knew about it. And I don't think it was as much of a joke as they thought. I actually think
No.
that it was here before we knew what was going on.
Yes.
Yeah, could have been.
China lies, dude.
Who
China lies through their teeth. But all in all, though, I'm glad to have you back in here, Jake.
I'm glad to be back. This is
Yeah.
pretty cool.
And yeah.
I've been off in, out
And
in the streets.
there's panic on the streets of London. Nah, except no panic, really. I mean, there was supposed to, quote unquote, be a riot yesterday, but or today,
Today, yeah.
but it got rained out, and also the people who organized it kind of effed off when everyone realized, wait, we don't actually know these people. And then they were just like, wait, where are you all from? And then they pretty much deleted their
Yeah,
profile.
apparently nobody knows if they're gonna be right or not. So, I mean, they said it wouldn't happen till dark, and yeah, who knows? Could be
Don't think it'll
today, could be
happen.
tomorrow. I don't think it'll
I
happen,
don't
who
think
knows?
it will, man. I mean,
Plus, it's piss
because.
pouring rain all day, so they're not gonna stand out in the rain.
Yeah. I mean, it's just. It's. The whole thing is. It's kind of scary, but at the same time, I am as protected as I can be because I got weapons. And if anyone does threaten this house and my life and the life of my friends, then there's gonna be some bad shit happen. And I don't want to do it, but that's just how it is. Anyway, speaking of bad shit, it seems as though in the last episode we were actually Jacob, I had to give Jacob a little bit of a recap
Yeah,
because I was
I
thinking
couldn't remember the
because
last
yeah, I don't remember
time
what
on
happened
episode.
either.
Okay, so the last thing that happened was Tsukasa sent some people to check on the village after they didn't believe the mentalist guy, forget his name. But after that, they sent the one dude with the spear and a bunch of goons, and it looked like they were going to make gunpowder, but instead they made katanas.
Oh,
And then
yeah.
they fought them off, and the one spear dude was actually doing really well against them, but the mentalist dude actually nicked the end of the spear, and the tip of the spear came off while they were fighting, while he was fighting, and thus he was left defenseless.
Yeah.
So now he's pretty much at the mercy of everyone in the village. So I guess we're just gonna have to see how this all pans out. So let's get this up on screen, and let's see what happens. Here we go. So there
That's
you
the
go.
one spoiler I've seen from the show, actually.
What?
Cell phones in the Stone Age or whatever, It's basically I saw him say that line at one point, so I knew that was going to be a
Oh,
thing at
maybe.
some point that they did.
Oh.
So
Well,
he did say it was going to be a small,
it was just
not
a little
necessarily a
clip where he's
smart
like,
one.
"We're going to make cell phones in the Stone Age," and I was just like, "That's weird." I was like, "Okay."
I was like,
I love seeing how shit's made like this,
I do
like from a
too.
ground. I mean, yeah, obviously it's an anime, it's not that easy, but like
No.
it kind of breaks it down to the
But still, I mean,
material level.
in terms of like the designing, the physics, don't get me wrong, they play with it because, for time and everything, but overall,
Still very real though. I
yeah,
mean,
it's very realistic.
it makes you
It's
start
more.
thinking and putting stuff together. I love it.
Well,
Get excited.
this right here is a commodity that a lot of people don't think about. We are literally standing on the shoulders of giants, everybody, because this stuff right here took years and years and years of work to make this a reality, make this a possibility, to where we can have literally a universal remote for life in our pocket. So, I mean, it's amazing, and the fact that they're creating this through an analog way, because a lot of this is digital, because it's got processing, like like silicon processors in it and everything. Whereas what they're doing there, I saw a vacuum tube, which vacuum tubes back in like the 50s and 60s were it, because tube radios, amplifiers, Everything used vacuum tubes.
Yeah, it's a very, like I said, small way for a step-up transformer.
Yes.
All it is, it just generates heat.
Yes.
Puts out more energy than came in it. So.
But my main worry is how they're going to get that much power, because unless they can do something to, like, harness the wind, because there's wind blowing down from the mountains, and if they can figure out a way to harness the wind with, like, wind turbines, stuff like that, to produce enough power for the thing to run.
Yeah, they're going to have to make repeaters or towers.
Yeah, and they talked about making a battery as well.
And those towers have to be powered in order to... how they're going to dial a signal, of course, that wouldn't be too hard.
Which,
as long as you make one frequency. And
they talked about making a battery, which an acid-based battery, you know, liquid acid-based battery can last a fairly long time. It's like a car battery, effectively.
Now, they can use types of... alkaline metals to make batteries. You'd have to get a lot of them, condense them a lot, and then add a charge to them, which sounds very dangerous.
Well, you add the charge to it. Well, I mean, they've got the generator, which, you know, can create energy, but you
just gotta make sure there's zero moisture in it, because it'll blow it up.
But for power production, you at least need some redundancy, something that's working around the clock all the time.
Yeah.
So, you know, like a renewable, like power, or for like wind power. They can't make solar panels yet. Mm-hmm. They might be able to in the future, but I'm not sure
what a solar panel actually consists of.
Well, it's glass.
I know how it works. I just don't know.
It's glass, cobalt, and copper. The cobalt absorbs the energy and converts it into kinetic energy, which goes into the copper wire, which goes to the where power feeds into.
And basically, it kind of just creates heat from the sun rays.
Yes, and cobalt is a heavy